Hello again, viewers, and greetings, fellow space travelers. This is Thorn of Night, and welcome to a blast from the past. I was on my computer looking for some old screenshots for showing something in Minecraft when I came upon some rather old save files. Back in around 2010, about Christmas time, I and a friend both decided to get Minecraft, and I at the time was using a computer to play it, and they had a desktop, so I would take my computer, my laptop over to their house, and we would play in a local game, and we were just basically doing our own thing, coming up with little ideas, testing some, starting huge projects, giving up on them, moving on to other huge projects, and giving up on them, moving on to others. And this went on for a very long time, several years. And the transitions in updates, let me turn the rain off and go ahead and, make it morning. The transitions from version to version made it so we had to do some updates to our builds from time to time, and it was an interesting learning process. I was not by any means a master builder or anything like that. I made nerd poles everywhere, but I also wanted to do some interesting stuff for building. I'm right now inside of his castle that he built, and I don't really know all the things that he put into it on the inside, all the secret passages and whatnot, because I do know he had secret passages, and I also know that he had this gigantic quarry that you could just see all the way straight down to bedrock, so I'm not going to inspect his castle too much, other than I will show you that he had some towers that you can get to from the inside. He had a little throne room, nice crenellations around the walls of the castle top there. A bridge, fountain, peasant shacks, and even a little church over here that you can get to from this way. He had some interesting projects of his own, too. Not to diminish what he was doing. Well, I can fly right now. Oh, this would have been so wonderful to do back then. Oh, flying. Wow. Yeah, there was no flying. There were just some huge differences. He had a little house over here. This was his first house upon arrival over on this side of the map that we had explored. And he started off with a little dirt hut, and then it turned into a house. And then he expanded over to a castle. But he had a glowstone roller coaster there that you can see. It doesn't function right now. His little house. This was also back when it was very important to make sure that you could clear around your doorway. There were issues with things still being able to see you through walls sometimes, and other stuff was going on. So we set up dispensers with arrows, and we had levers and timers and whatnot to activate and shoot the bad guys near the door. We'd lure them different directions and shoot them. But those are fun times. But I'm going to show you a whirlwind tour of a lot of the things that we were doing on here just to have fun, or just to investigate the game, basically. Oh, this was our starting little outpost. Wow, I remember this. Jack-o'-lanterns down there. We could get in. Here be home. Wow. All the feels, man. This is just surreal. One of the things that we were doing was we discovered we could grow trees next to each other in little cylinders. Oak trees only. The other trees don't cooperate like that. And we were trying to make gigantic trees, and so I, not to be outdone, he did this one, so I decided, why not just crank it up to 11? I did this one, and it looks horrible. And this was not placed logs. This was, I placed some dirt, then towered up on top of the tree that grew and placed more dirt and so on and so forth until I had a cylinder roughly that tall. And then I did it one more time, made a few branches, and there we go. The end result. There's nothing much up there other than the way on the inside. Another thing that I did, because why not? Oh, and he also put a false sun up in the sky. That was kind of fun. Now, keep in mind, all of this stuff was done in survival. All the resources gathered by hand. We had dig sites and quarries and things, and this was just ridiculously time-consuming, but we still did it. This is one of my first attempts at a sand castle, where everything is supported by a torch. This is the only sand that's on the ground. Everything else supported by torches. Here, this one torch, if I break that, this whole thing comes falling down. Which reminds me, let's make sure. Yep, I guaranteed it is on peaceful. Good. But everything in this is 100% supported by torches. And we come over to the stairs to the second floor. I never really did anything in here decoration-wise on up to the third floor, but this is, oh, the sand was here so that I would not accidentally continue running forward while jumping up. It's a little observation ring up here, and the floor down below, this was just, well, also for observation, but in addition, I was going to use it as a place to put, like, chests and furnaces and beds and things, but never got around to it. Ooh, what's that? A gravel cactus. Okay. I don't even remember that. Some of these things are just, I'm discovering them or rediscovering them. This is just wild. I wanted you to view this with me because now I know that this was, wait a minute, there's a road over here. I'm going to take the road. Oh, flying. Oh, so nice. Oh, so nice. See, he built his castle, and I decided that I wanted to be able to visit, so I connected a road from my castle to his. And when I did that, he decided that he wanted to have some other little things along the way. This is a couple of guard towers, and this was supposed to be a sort of a drawbridge to inhibit traffic into this bay here. Oh wait, the bay. Oh, hold. Well, I'll look at this in a bit. But this actually does connect to a series of bodies of water that just go on and on and on. As far as we can tell, it became an arbitrarily large body of water that just went and went and went. It was kind of cool. It wasn't an ocean. There weren't oceans back then. It was just a very large, very connected sequence of bodies of water. But the path here, it comes over to another little lookout, I think. And if I, yes, okay. There's the other path. Haha. Why am I staying on the path? I can fly. We found a surface dungeon, and it was a spider dungeon of all things. And so I don't know what the door was. I don't even know how with an update the door. That's weird. Okay, whatever. But spider spawner in this dungeon. We cleared out all the loot, and we had a little place where we'd stand on the roof and then guide things this way. And just stand right here, and the spiders would try to get at us. They would die on the cactus, and their string and spider eyes would come over here. Actually, I don't think there were even spider eyes back then. Right, let's get back to the road. I'm not going to walk along it, but I will follow it. This is so surreal. Oh, this was going to be access to a little quarry of mine that I reached from my castle. I'm going to first go up to my... I guess I have to go inside this way. This is my observation slash lighthouse slash, I don't know, spying place, something. Oh, the glowstone. Yes, the glowstone. Oh, I can see all kinds of stuff from up here. This is where... Oh, neat. The distance. Wow. Optifine would have been amazing back then. Anyway, moving on. Don't want to stick around too long. Had this courtyard with this giant tree that I was trying to grow sculpt. This is one of the entrances to my castle. Great big dining hall. Yes, I know it's hard to see because of the shaders, but there's the throne. And I also had this little down here, this panic sleeping area to make it morning, because this I was working on this for a long time, and when we wanted it to be morning, I had to be near bed at all times. That was always a concern. There are four towers, so I built stairs that went up to the four different towers. Wow. I remember all this. Let's make it morning again. And follow the road over across the bridge to this outpost here. Now, I could go down and outside, follow that, and that leads me to the access to where I was building that. Alright, and then I think, if I am remembering correctly, yes! And this is updated! Yes! Okay, now before, all of our minecarts were the collision carts with the infinite speed boost, because that was the only way to do it. And then an update happened that introduced booster track, and we started trying to convert all the rails in our map to fit this, and most of our travel was by rails. So let's go down here. Oh, the subway. Yes, the subway! I remember it! Wow. Yep, there was a booster. No longer do we have to deal with infinite collision physics. I believe this will lead to a way station. Oh, man. Oh, yep, here's the way station. Okay, so Spoot Castle, that was the name of the castle area. Okay, and then this way station here. Let's see. There must have been a reason for it. Oh, this is Atlantis. Oh, underwater dome city. Yes. With my McDonald's. See the lovely golden arches. It's so different underwater with the shaders. I'm sorry. This looked a lot cooler without the shaders. I should turn it off, but you know what? I'm just going to leave it on because I want to force myself to acclimatize to the shaders. Yeah, I had the menu. I had a little park really hastily thrown together brick house thing. I had a little hedge garden. Cool. Alright, moving on. Alright, I think we're approaching the outpost now. Yep, here it is. Oh, this is the Atlantis Way Station. That's what it says on the sign. This is the Atlantis Way Station. Alright, this is the midway point. Just curious, I want to see if this is... Okay, yeah, alright, so what we did was, every once in a while we would overshoot our destination, and so, instead of going all the way to the end of the line, we would build these way stations, so we'd stop here and go, no, I didn't mean to go to Atlantis, I wanted to go the other way. So I'm going to hit outpost. Alright, we are here at the outpost, Atlantis outpost, yes. Okay, so what this was the connection point between some of his builds, his water, or his castle, and then the water base. But I want to see what this rail leads. Well, okay. I don't remember where this goes. I'm sorry for the slowness. There we go. Oh, well, that was brief. Where is this? This must have been something of his. That looks like a mine shaft. Yep, this is his. Okay, this was his little house that led to the roller coaster. Now I know how he got here. I never knew before. Neat. I never took this path. I'm just gonna fly back down here. Because there's lots more to look at. I need to go to the water base. Welcome to water base. Okay, so that goes to the Atlantis, and that a button goes to the main station. So, just some basic storage. This, I know for a fact, goes down to the mining operations. And here's the water base. It's just this underwater little base here that is closer to a lot of the builds that we had. I will show you some of these other things in a moment. Let's continue on to the main station. So here we are at the main station, and this was a doozy to put together. All sorts of different rails, and basically this is the launch point for the station. And if I zoom in here, I have different cities. This is Aloft, and this is Lux. Then we can go to the water base, and then the Foyer Mountain Hall. You know, I think I'll go to Aloft next, but let's see where we are right here. But basically, you change the destination, and there's a wall of nonsense in here. Or not a wall, but a room of nonsense, I should say. For changing to different destinations. I think I overclicked. There we go. Aloft. And we had a few more tied on to this, but we wanted to disable them temporarily until we got all of the other tracks up to the booster and convertible direction things. All right. Press for cart. Oh, yeah. So we have... Okay, so this takes you up and out. So this really is just a sort of a way station. Alright. This is just a switching hub. So I don't think I want to be here right now. So let's go to Aloft. What's in here? More minecarts. So, switched to Aloft. Launch the cart. And off we go. Oh, this was the remnants of... Oh no, this is a return track. Okay, yeah, I remember that. Alright. We are at Aloft. I think I hear rain, so let's get that out of here. And let's make it morning. There we go. Welcome to Aloft Station. Now, Aloft was one of my projects, and I spent a lot of time on it, both building and gathering resources. This is the station for the actual Aloft landing point with a little bridge to park that I grew and sculpted So many creeper explosions happened here. Hence all the glowstone. I was just terrified of creepers at the time. So, glowstone everywhere. But this is a magnificently large city. And it's totally not even done. I was starting work on it, and then we had more ideas, and then just things happened. I never finished this, but it was going to be glorious, and it already is. It's huge. Let me get out of here. Let me fly up a little. This pathway, first off, it is a circle, but it tilts down to the ground here. The other end is much higher in the air. And I was dividing this into different elemental districts. It was going to be like a magical city, and there were totems or temples or whatever to each of the four different, I guess, Minecraft elements. And then there was a city that was being built in the middle platform, but this road goes all the way around. And all of these, just to remind you, all these resources, everything you see was hand harvested and cooked and placed in survival. Hence the beds everywhere. But let's go take a look inside a loft. This is the desert, the dry element, I guess. The warm, this is, no? Well, it's the desert element. I'll just call it the desert element. Fine, whatever. But it was supposed to resemble a sort of Egyptian-style pyramid, and in the back here was the totem to the desert spirit, as it were. And you may have noticed that we have not encountered, in my tour here, we have not encountered any villagers or villages. That's because they didn't exist. Alright, let's move on to this one over here. Now, there are two different paths. The first one, this goes down to the... Yes, this goes down to the spirit totem of the Nether, basically. And I've got all this netherrack and fire. We will encounter this eventually, but this was all built back when you could do every other ladder. Let's go through this winding mountain maze. It's not really a maze, it's just a path. Because not only do each of the... I left a little window to see out. Not only do each of the different, districts of the city have a totem, but they also just have a representation of the look and feel of what they're supposed to be. This is nether, fire, and lava, and netherrack, and there's some obsidian and all that in there. But I could go back up to the top that way, but instead, each of the four districts also had their own little subway. So let's go down. This was a very intensive project I did. All of the subway... You can see that this is sandstone. And you can see that this is sandstone. So I want to go... this is that old design. I bet if I hit that button, this powers off again. We'll find out. Let's go... Oh, no, it worked. Let's go on around. Okay, so let's look at this. We had... I thought for sure I was supposed to have a sign here, but whatever. That would take me back to there, so I want to go to this one. Wait, hold on. Let's see where I am. If this is the white district, yeah, I don't want to be here right now. Whoa. Whoa, hey now. Oh! This is access to out here so I could get some additional resources. I forgot this existed. You know what? Instead of taking the rail, let's just fly over. Whee! Much faster to fly. Who knew that fly was going to be a thing? Let me down. And we would have come up there. Alright, into the mouth of the forest district. And the way I set this up is this big honking tree here in the middle actually is the spirit totem for the forest. But on top of that, these trees are important. If you do some climbing and jumping, it will take you up to the very tippy top up here. This was very fun to build, by the way. I loved this. And out to the central district. So there we have it. This is a loft city. Now, I also had from nearby access, you've been probably catching glimpses of it from time to time. There's the way we came in to the aloft subway and all the little gatehouses and everything. And I was going to also have additional cities or districts between the totem districts, but I never got around to it. Never did. Because I had lots of other projects, and one of those other projects included, I wanted to start building giant mushrooms. Just because. So, I had these built mushrooms here. There weren't actual giant mushrooms, I don't believe. So, this was just an idea that I had. I just hastily slapped together some mushroom apartments, red and white. Brown mushrooms, well, red and beige mushrooms, whatever. They are the same, but I also put together this main mushroom mansion. Main mushroom mansion. I have two flights of stairs, and I don't remember which is which. Oh, yeah, dogs. I was so fascinated with catching dogs. Didn't even know you could breed them either. Alright, so this was the renter's apartment. And this was down here where the common hall was. Never really did anything with this. And this was the main apartment up here that I claimed as my own. I had the giant fire pit with the netherrack. And in the middle is a furnace, just because. And this is my little study with chairs and bookcases everywhere. No enchanting or anything like that. Where's my bed? I had a bed. Oh, there it is. No, that's the stairs. Oh, there it is. There's my bed. And had views out the windows. Now, there's a UFO over there. We'll get to that next. I want you to see that as well, but I just wanted you to see the inside of this. Let me get back out of here. Oh, quick side note on the way over to the UFO. This was a world-spawned block of still lava. We did everything we could to not interact with it at all ever, because we didn't want to cause a block update and make it turn into gloopy lava. But, yeah, just left that be. It was just a thing. There it was. Now, I'm going to do this sort of backwards. Well, first off, here we have the companion cube. I was responsible for this nonsense. When I discovered... Oh, are you kidding me? When I discovered pink wool, pink sheep, I started gathering the sheep and the wool whenever I could. And slowly, over time, I gathered enough to finish this project, and it's hollow on the inside, as I recall. But this is my UFO, and the beam-up site was this little channel of water, and it also went a little further down. I don't even know. I think Yeah, this also has access to some mines, I believe. Yep. Yeah, this is. Hold on, let me get down here. Oh, this was the mob spawning area! Oh, great big dark rooms, and everything came into these lava knives that just automatically killed everything, and I was using that to get arrows and stuff. Oh, I remember that! Nostalgia, all the feels. But let's beam ourselves up into the UFO here. Obviously, swimming is a lot slower than this, but have a little platform to see around. View distance was not nearly this far before. But, yeah, here we are. Don't know what I was wanting to do with it, but I built it anyway. Just a great big UFO. Oh, aha! Aha! This, before booster tracks, was how you got around. You set yourself down in a minecart here. And then there was another minecart. Let's see if I can convince us to go up the hill. Alright. No, 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 no. Okay, fine. Be that way. I will just push you like that. And it would land on top of the door. And then you'd have a minecart there. You get in, you sit down, and push the button. And ideally, the door would flap. And this is oriented wrongly now because of updates. But the door would flap, the minecart would fall, it would start coasting down the ramp, they would collide with each other, that one would fly back up on top and reset, and this would boost all the way to its destination with an infinite amount of momentum. And so we had this little sky rail here. Went up and over. Over to the Mountain Foyer Hall. And that's where we're going next. This was the access tower to the Mountain Foyer Hall, but I'm just going to shortcut it and bring us down here to the bottom. Huh! Wow, updates. Oh, another one of the door traps to keep skeletons and stuff at bay. And as I recall, last time, yeah, there was only one of these that still had arrows. I set up this, let me come back up top here. I set up this chamber here with a whole bunch of dispensers. After I discovered dispensers, I became fascinated. So at the push of a button, push button for new gear. Now keep in mind, we had a lot of resources because we dug a lot. So I'm going to push this button, and here comes full diamond gear, and tools, and a compass, and torches, and arrows, and food, and everything. This is also back when food didn't stack. Just lots of stuff. Golden apples. Neat. Look at all these torches. That was so cool. Oh, wait. I remember through this door, there was another room. Yes. And I trapped a wolf here before I tamed it, and it was there forever because we never left the area. It was fun times, fun times. Alright, into the mountain foyer. There is, I believe, this is the access to that tower that we arrived in. And this is access to the subway. Alright. All the fields. What's in here? Oh, an infinite water supply. Right. I don't remember. Oh, wait. That's the upper floor. Let me see what this takes me to. Whoa. Going down. Where? Okay, this is the hub. All right, well then, I guess it's time to go on. Oh, let's not kill the machine. Time to go on to Lux Station. Okay, I think we're approaching the destination here. Lux Station. There we go. We've been to the UFO, been to the main station, so it is toggled for harbor next. Okay, good. So let's get out here. Lux Station, everyone. You can see the UFO from this distance on Optifine. That's cool. Lux Station was basically supposed to be the meeting place for all the cities that we were building, or rather, that I was building. Lots and lots of storage. This was before you could set a chest on top of another chest. Chests were bigger than physical objects, and you just couldn't open one when they were sitting on top of one another. But you could open them if they were spaced by fences. So that's what that is. Oh, the dock. Doop doop doo. After an update, this turned to an ice biome. So, wait, no, this always was an ice biome. That's right. I just had to work around it. My first boat, it was so horrible and somewhat embarrassing. Didn't even have slabs I could place on the bottom for extra detail. The sails were rubbish. A little red flag up there. I don't even remember. Yeah, there was access to the below decks area. With some storage and cannons, obviously cannons with arrows, because why not? Wow. All right. This, at the point where I got the backup save for this file, Lux was never finished, and Lux was a glorious thing. It had these parapets and just these wizard towers, and just it was hideous looking. Oh, so bright. Glowstone everywhere. Lapis, gold blocks. It was just the brightest eyesore you could imagine. Horribly designed houses, just hastily put together just because I wanted to have this dual city. And what I mean by dual city is to accompany the bright and bold Lux. There was also down underneath the platform here, which I remember this is all built in survival. Let me make this daytime again. So the city here, this is called Underdark or Everdark? Everdark. And I had shops, and this is right after I discovered that slabs and things like pressure plates and stuff that occupied the lower portion of a block prevented the mobs from spawning. So we have the food grocer. There is Hank's halfway house. Oh, this is like a tavern or something. Uh-oh. It wasn't like that before, I promise. This is just an alleyway. And everything was lit with redstone torches. Community message board, post no bills. Child Lost and Gloom. Gloom, I was going to actually move some of the city, or sort of dig down and make this sort of sewery kind of secondary Underdark, the slums of Under or Everdark, and call it the Gloom. Seeking help. We'll fix anything for a price. Help needed. Seek Marl. Haha. Furnishings and appliances. What is all this? Nothing. Oh! Beds and chairs and tables. Okay. Oh, and the little docking thing so that. That's right. Because you could shear cobwebs and get the cobwebs back. Warehouse unloading and loading only. But yeah, this is all dark. Everything slabs, no real light. All the way up until I decided to start laying out where I wanted the entrance to the gloom to be, and that was back here. So. This is the Twin Cities of Lux and Everdark. incomplete, unfortunately. You should be able to see the full eyesore glory that was this pair of cities. So let's move on with this tour. Another thing that you need to know is this was all built way back when you could do water scaffolding. Behind this corner, inside, was water. And, or actually, it only worked in one direction. I think it was this one. Yes, it was this one. So, what you'd do is you'd run at water, and the water physics glitched through the corner, and so you could climb up seemingly invisible water and end up here. So, that was definitely taken out. One last view of this area before we move on. Okay, now this is going to be the, I guess, end of the line, but this isn't even close to done yet. Let's move on. Now, I could take the subway, but when achievements were added, one of them was the kilometer long track. So that's what this is. This is a 1 kilometer track of just necessity, basically. Just started building. We had the resources. Man, did we have the resources. Oh! Around Christmas time, I decided to make a little Christmas tree there. Hello. Somewhere. We made a creeper face, and I don't remember where it was. I'm sure we'll find it. Alright, there are a few things that we're going to see along the way here. Coming up on the right are a bunch of netherrack buoys that we used to guide us before we had the subway, basically, built out this far. And over there was a boathouse, which led to another boathouse. There's my Torii gate, my Japanese-style house, and there's some gardens over there. I had this walkway that went up, bridged across to a mountain, and then the mountain had an output with a path that led to this hideous thing that he was building. Ah, there it is. Right there. What that means? There's the creeper face. Yes! Ha-ha! Didn't get it full-on view, but there it is. And I don't know what he was doing stuff down here. Sorry about the jerking. That's the cinematic effect. He's doing something. But at the end of this track, which we're coming up on, I had one last little thing going on, and it was... There we go. I didn't want to keep talking over the rails. Rails didn't used to make noise, folks. There's one. I had this idea after watching Pitch Black. And seeing those hive swarms of things that came out of the ground, I was wanting to make these drop holes that led down to these broods, these spawning broods of things. And I surrounded it with water. This is supposed to represent mucus. And then at the very, very bottom here, I was going to start clearing out the area and making these hand-built egg pods and other kind of stuff. And this is another one of those projects that I never really got around to finishing. I started but never finished. But this was probably the longest lasting world that I played on and continually did stuff on. This was just amazing. I cannot imagine how many hours that were spent doing all of the projects that we did. Let's go ahead and fly over to my Japanese house just to finish it off. Oh, right there, that nerd pole there, that was going to be another hive. There was another one over there, and I think another one over there. There were supposed to be four. And then I was going to have up in the sky, I was going to start building these bird things that were all going to be flying this way, and then they were going to be chasing a dragon, which was going to be visible from my Japanese house. So, this was my first attempt at a stylized structure, and even at this point, I was still infatuated with dogs, but instead of having a million of them, I just have the one. Now, I have not tested this. I want to see. This is my dog. I want to see if it'll let me. It still knows it's me! Yes! Yes! Hello! All these were captured individually. Oh, man. And they're all sad, too. I don't know why. This is just a thing. A lot of them probably need to be fed by now. But, this was also back in the time when they had to always be seated because we would accidentally punch each other. Just accidentally, like, we were trying to dig something, one of us would walk in front of the other and just bonk, and then all of our dogs zerg rushed the person being attacked. Or the person doing the attacking. And so we had to seat all of our dogs and never let them follow us ever again. It was so sad, we grounded them all. Okay, come on, no rain. This was my boathouse. Back then, soul sand was used to buffet the boats from colliding and turning into sticks and planks. That was nice. This was my chicken farm. And what I did was I had a timer set up down here with some redstone that's not visible right now. And I'd fill all these with eggs, and then I'd turn the timers on, and it would shoot out eggs, and I'd wait for them to mature, and then I would go in and slaughter all the chickens. Lots and lots and lots of chickens were harmed in the making of this part of my map. Oh, also, started getting seeds from grass. I remember that. The way to get seeds, you didn't punch grass. You don't see grass anywhere here. And that's because it didn't spawn. In order to get grass, you had to till a grass block to get a chance of getting seeds. Oh, also the infinite mushroom spread. Oh, wow. I remember that too. Infinite mushroom spread. That was so horrible. So this is where we got bread, and bread never stacked. Found mushrooms. Found some pumpkins. There were no melons back then. Oh, man. This has been quite the trip down memory lane. But I'm going to come up on. Oh, where's this path go? Oh, right. I'm going to come up here and observe the realm. Oh, you couldn't pass through these back then either. Haha. I'm going to come up here, observe my realm in the sunlight and the no grass waving in the breeze anywhere. And I'm going to go ahead and wrap up. This has been wonderful. A very nostalgic trip through the past. This is 6 years ago? Yeah, 6 years ago. Probably a little less when I finally stopped working on this map, and then a couple years later I managed to get a backup copy and to keep for myself, but the actual final copy no longer to be had. So sad. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please feel free to leave a message in the comment section below. I am more than happy to respond. If you like this video and you want to see some more just survival builds, just straight up things like this. I might be able to dredge some up from some other save files, maybe if I can find them. If you want to see them, let me know. If not, I may do it, I may not. Just let me know what you think. If you like this video, do give a like. I appreciate it, and it does help. And if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe. I've got a lot of stuff going on and a lot more stuff coming. But I'm going to let you go now. Thank you very much for watching. This is Thorn of Night in a blast from the past, reaching all the way back to Christmas of 2010. Wow. I will talk to you later.